What's up, everybody? Well, today I'm working on some spoiler alert. Oh, spoiler alert! Seriously, if you don't want Songbringer spoiled for you, you shouldn't be watching this video or this stream. Because I'm going to be working on lots of story elements, which are kind of like, what? That happens in the game? Alright, you've been warned. So, right now I'm stuck in this room for some reason. If I save and load here, this is only going to ever happen in debug mode, but I still want to figure out what's going on because you should never be stuck in a room like this. Maybe this would actually happen in release mode in some circumstance. So, anyways, these doors are meant to be locked when you first come in here and he drops this bomb, but then they're supposed to unlock. So, what is happening that it's not unlocking? Gotta figure that out. So, this, I want to see. Do I have something where it's like completion verbosity? I don't think I do, no. Okay, so this is gonna be in like get completion factor. Get completion factor. You notice I'm using Vim now. I'm gonna try it out, actually using it today's stream. I had another little Vim explosion of learning. Oh, here it is. Here's one way it looks at its completion factor, but there's another one too. That's check completion. Oh my god, it's so fast! Oh, so much better than Xcode in some ways. I hope I can actually make this switch to Vim soon. Getting close. Oh, there it is. Here's one way. This is one way to look at the, so it's on, wait. I'm trying to think about how to do things the smartest way here. If I just want to delete those two things, I would go delete to, no. Delete to A. Oh, that's the little A. Okay, undo that. Delete to capital A. There we go. Write that. Run it. Kind of helps to say things out loud. It's like, it was really hard for me to try and learn Vim at first and do streaming because, gosh, they both require such a lot of, different. It's like just to program and talk is hard enough. Okay, there it is, 100% of its completion, and it hasn't opened or unlocked these doors. So, gotta figure out why it's not unlocking these doors. So I gotta set a breakpoint. Now I've hit the limits of my Vim. Basically, I want to go set a breakpoint right here and figure out why it's not doing this activate area complete thing. Okay, so I got to go back to check completion. Let's figure out. Actually, we'll go if completion factor. Oh my god, god. Things take so long compared to Vim to code here. If completion factor is greater than or equal to 1.0, set a breakpoint. Okay, there. It's all good. We're all good here. Looks like good. Yeah, good, good, good. Does it really take this long? Alright, so we're gonna see here that we get to 100%. And yeah, it triggers this breakpoint, but something happens. Collision system is complete. Are you not complete? Alex Pita! What's up? Ciao Bello! Bella Zio, man. Is it Bellazio or Bellozio? How you been, man? What's going on? What's new? So if the story system is running actions, is it? No. Is the puzzle complete? There are some puzzles? No, there's a bunch of... Okay. Let's set breakpoints here and here. Okay, so it's here. Ah, so it's probably counting the live foes. You're good? Right on. It's Bellozio. Okay, so does Bellozio mean something too? Does that... Why is it Bella and not... Is there Bello? Why is it Bella? I'm trying to understand. Oops. So I get in here to count live K-filter foe. It's probably still going to have a foe. Wait, what is actually checking? No, it actually killed this foe. Okay, wait a minute. So if we continue out of this function... return false. Okay, so it's returning true because it's counting the number of live foes. And they're... Okay, let's figure out which ones are returning that. So let's get rid of all the other breakpoints we're not using. Darth Vader is Luke's father! Pedro, what's up, man? How you been? We don't need that. We don't need this. We just need these two. And we turn this one off. Turn this one off. Dude, what the hell? There we go. Run it. Bella's beauty. But Italian, it's like, what's up? Right? Okay. But is there a Bello? Zio. Today's a holiday? What's your holiday, man? Okay, so I'm enabling this breakpoint. I want to see which AI is the thing that's still alive. Because we're right in the thing where it's killing that one guy. The one person that should be alive here. Super Bomb Foe! Oh, the bomb is still alive? That should never be counted as alive. You didn't have to work. Nice. Happy holiday. Okay, I'm pretty sure is alive checks if it has a K health, no lock. And the Super Bomb Foe should have that. So its health component has flags, no lock. I believe that's how it goes. Yeah, health, flags, no lock. Cool. Okay, so now we should run it again, and this time it shouldn't still be stuck. What's up, HD? Oh, the Restoration of Independence. In 1640. The 1600s and the 1700s were a big time for that, huh? Okay, you good? Right on. See if we hit that other breakpoint. Well, we'll get in here. Collision system is complete. Let's just run it. Nice, it worked. The door's back open back up. Ugh, I can't believe that. So the Super Bomb Foe was technically still alive. It's so weird. Why would it ever... It shouldn't have ever considered... Oh, the Super Bomb Foe has hit points because... It has hit points because you can. You should be able to kill it. Like you, there's some things that can kill the super bomb foe. So really a better way to solve this though is that when the super bomb foe dies, it should check the completion factor, but for some reason it's not. Right? Yeah. That's the two sentence version of it all. But yeah, I'm sure it was a lot more involved than that. Man, so 1640, huh? That's what you guys celebrate, that date. So when the super bomb foe dies, it really should be checking the completion, and it's not. This happens in health system when a boss dies, but also when a regular foe dies. Let's set a breakpoint here and figure out why the super bomb foe isn't calling that. Really? They came to celebrate? That's kind of. How do you take that? How do you take that? It seems like a nice gesture, I guess, but. Oh, the super bomb foe. Right, so, what foe is this that's dying? This is the lightning boss. Completion factor. Oh, the super bomb foe never dies? Oh, maybe it just doesn't ever die. It's kind of weird, yeah. Diplomatic stuff. They were casing the joint. Oh, man. I shouldn't. Is that okay to laugh at that? Is that funny? All right, so it doesn't ever call on foe death. Probably because when a bomb dies, that's just mood explode. And when it's done with its mood explode, it doesn't necessarily call to kill all its hit points. I'm just going to put a note here. Some bombs, like Super Bomb Foe, have hit points and either need to be killed via change HP or have health no lock. All right, there. Now I've got a note just to remember that. And I want to go back to the super bomb foe and turn this back on and get rid of this little catchy statement I wrote here. And this bug should be fixed. It went to your Senate. King made a speech. Oh man. Oh, they didn't clap. Right. Oh, I hope not. You're welcome. Let's make sure that I got what, hold on, let's see. What I change? Flags no lock. Add this little note. Oh, I also want to undo this change to collision system, which is right here. Okay, now let's run it. Make sure it works. Okay, so the lightning boss guy should drop his bomb, and after he's done, the doors will unlock. Man, this is kind of important. I wonder if this fixed a different bug I was dealing with. Good. There, the doors are opening. All right, very, very good. This is good to have that fixed. Let's go up here and fight the boss. Save here. And let's check this in. Once again, all I did was add this flags no lock and a note to AI system. Oh, I got my data.vim. Should I keep that? No, I'm not using that. Wait, no, I am. Yeah. Let's add this to my gitignore. Wait, I'm trying to use the right Vim commands here. So Shift A is going to add, start editing at the end of that line. Then I can go data.vim, escape, right, quit, get status. And now it's just going to ignore data.vim. Sweet. Check that in. Okay, so fixed super bomb foe. Accidentally keeping doors locked. Well, I can use colon X to close with changes. There we go. And FG to get back to my Vim session. So sweet, man. I'm freaking loving Vim. Awesome. Okay. The next thing I want to do is, when you fight the lightning boss here, and it goes after you fight the lightning boss, there's some story elements that happen. So I'm gonna get those fixed up a little bit. There's some more story element I wanna do here. So right now there's kind of some placeholder dialogue and stuff. I want that to be cooler. So I'm just gonna kill the boss using debug keys. Okay, and I saved. Okay, cool. So we're set up so we can chest out these things. So first of all, it segues to show the lightning boss stealing. Once again, this is a spoiler alert. Big old spoiler alert stream. Don't watch this if you don't want things spoiled. She steals the dark coil or the dark matter, whatever you want it, whatever it is that powers Songbringer's engines. And this is where this placeholder dialogue is. I want this dialogue to become an actual talk with Captain Tusk. So Captain Tusk will use the holocom to appear right here, and he will have some dialogue. Instead of you being like, "Oh my God, I gotta run because the ship alarm's going off," it's gonna be Captain Tusk saying, "Yo, we just detected that somebody stole the dark coil. You better get off the ship because it's going down." Lurking anyway, right on. What's up, Zelda Ethan? How you doing, man? What's new? Okay, so step one, we need to be able to spawn Captain Tusk here on this screen. We'll need to set his skin so he's using a different type of thing, so he looks like he's on the holocom, and he'll need to have some dialogue for this section. So a lot of different story elements that need to happen here. But first thing, we need to spawn Captain Tusk after this story event. So let's go to story, and this is Lightning Boss Victory. No, it's not Lightning Boss Victory. Oh, I think it's Shipfall. Just my brain is like, how do I do that in Vim? Ship engine one, ship falling. There it is. All right, so it starts off by saving. Then it gives you the item ship fall one so that it can trigger a lot of these other events. It delays, it segues to the ship engine, delays. I guess that delay actually was about the right amount of time. And then it does a lens shake and an IMS and all this. I'm going to go ahead and comment out this segue to the ship engine for now so that I can focus on just the part where it spawns Captain Tusk and all that. Let's comment that. And this. My poor brain. Okay. Insert. Semicolon. Escape. Okay, so lens, anims, delay, dialogue, ship falling. Here's right where we want to put spawning Captain Tusk. Captain Tusk is not an entity yet on his own, so he needs to become an entity. So we're going to need to put him in his own file. Okay, so he's in entities right now. Let's find him. Captain, profile Captain Tusk, all that. Okay, he needs to become his own profile. Shift V. Delete. Right now, edit a new file, data, friends, or maybe it should be neutrals. Doesn't matter really. Neutrals is fine. Data, neutrals. Oh, he's not a neutral. I guess he's a friend. Maybe one day he actually will be part of the game where he follows you or something. I don't know. Data, friends, Captain Tusk. Now let's paste this. All right, now I need to format it like it's its own file. Delete that line. Go to the beginning of this line. Insert attributes. Go to the next line, insert a tab. Okay, he's got name, Captain Tusk, profile, animations. Oh, how do I indent a whole block of text? You just finished editing an icon? Right on. Nice, Ethan. All right, indenting a whole block of text. I would select the whole block, I think, and then press. Let's figure this out. Oh wait, I could do visual. Hold on, I could do. Control V mode, visual block, and then just delete that. Oh, that worked. Hell yeah, that worked. Nice. Okay. And the rest of these are attributes. So once again, I can not use the visual block mode, but use visual line mode and delete all these lines, put them up here. Yeah, all right, we got attributes, name, Captain Tusk, position, render, collision, reflection, dialogue, Let's put reflection up with render. And I guess that should be good for now. Let's write that. Now, when we create a Captain Tusk on the bridge, that's in create NPC tile. Okay, and this we're on the ship and the ship bridge. We want to do name Captain Tusk. Ooh, I'm starting to get better. Yay, per vim. Is there anything else here? No, there's a rock face and Smith have some special code, but I think that should be enough. Now let's go back to the ship. All right, find position and we want to be at, let's go back to the ship. We want to be at, what's that? 0, 1, -2. Escape, save. Run the game. We'll see if, okay, we got Captain Tusk as his own entity and he's still on the bridge. Yeah, there he is. Cool. Did I already do some of this dialogue? Let's see if we can get some of his dialogue to run to make sure he's doing that all right. And also mess with his position a little bit. So back to Captain Tusk. Here we go. What if his position was like -20? What's up, Rocket Bunny? Yeah, good. Okay, so we modified his position and he's definitely a lot lower. Okay, so let's undo last change. Write this again. Now, I don't need to be here. Wait, I do want to be on the bridge. I want to take away if it's I want to look for, search for ship bridge. Yeah, we want to take away ship bridge 2. So I'm going to delete to the next space. Okay, I should have done delete forward to the next space. That would have gotten included the space. Okay, let's run it again. This time we should see some dialogue. Here we go. Cool. This is where he gives you the ship quest. Awesome, and his dialogue is working fine. His animation worked fine as well. Good. Okay, we got him set up now. He's his own entity, meaning it's a separate data file for him instead of it being inside of entities.txt. So now I want to spawn him and have him do a little bit of dialogue. So we want to go to story. We spawn Captain Tusk. Let's see if, we already got dialogue ship falling. So let's go to dialogue ship falling. And let's see if we can put Captain Tusk in here. I disabled my arrow keys in insert mode, so I'm like learning better stuff here with Vim. You have a bit of a problem. The school's dancing tomorrow. 3 girls asked you? That's right, yeah. But you don't really know them. What should you do? Oh, that's a great question. Well, close your eyes for a second and tell me which one of them you like the most, just off the top of your head. Kiss him on the cheeks. Do you have an instinct for which one you like the most, or you're just somehow attracted to the most, or is there one, or do you kind of have the same feeling for all of them? What is your instinct telling you, man? Okay, so we'll write some text for Captain Tusk. Captain Tusk is gonna say, "Yo!" Just to see if he can say anything at all. 1, 2, 3. Cool, we got some text for him. Let's see what happens. You really don't know them. Okay. You have the feeling, you have the same feeling for all of them. What's up, Loki Kappa? Set up your own game show where they compete for the chance to win. Yes, splice them in. Awesome idea. Yeah, right? Do you have, okay, so wait, the dance is tomorrow? You got all the way till tomorrow to figure out which one you could go with. Hey, do they have a problem with going three girls all with one guy? Probably, knowing American girls. Rocket Bunny. It's gonna look weird, right? Yeah. Oh man, I'm trying to come up with some really creative solutions, but I think we're like, I like Weissman's solution. Like Weissman's solution. Seriously, can you create some kind of thing where you can get to know all of them and do something where you can choose one? Like, I don't know. Can you like do something tonight? Like right now? Just invite them all to something, and that way you can kind of get to know them a little bit. Or yeah, see which one's the smartest, whatever. Yeah. I'm gonna go to okay. Well, come at this position, go back to here. What's up, Lou? What are you, Dev? What happened? Oh, it tried to spawn, and then it's like, ah, you can't spawn. It's just immediately quitting. All right, well, let's figure out why. Why are you immediately quitting? What the hell? No debt, nothing. This is weird. All right, log text. What happened, log text? It's missing an input component. Oh. This is weird though. I wonder why it didn't. Like, it should have showed me that. It should have showed this entire line in the log.txt, but it didn't. Three-legged race. It threw a paddling pool full of custard. Yes. I like Weissman's suggestions a lot. All right, so let's give Captain Tusk an input component. No matter the weirdness. Captain Tusk. All right, give him an input component. Not insert. I want to insert after the whole line. Input flags 8. Like, well, if he were to have input or whatever, he would be able to walk in 8 different directions. I'm gonna run it from X. Wait, I don't need to run it from Xcode. I can run it from anywhere because I'm just looking at the log.txt. What's up, Salad Dogs? Printing imminent. He does. We need ideas. Oh, hey, here he is. Okay, he says, yo. Captain Tusk is apparently at the bottom left of the screen. I want to look at some other examples. Can I open up? Wait, no, I want to not do that. I want to edit data foes. Not foes. I want to edit. I want to get Brutus open. Is he a neutral? Where's Brutus? I don't know where Brutus is. Is he a friend? Oh, he's a friend. Okay. I need to get some kind of fuzzy finder app or plugin. Make grunting noises? What's up, Scissor? Can we expect to see the game anytime soon? The short answer is no. Let me give you the long answer. What's that command? Ah, Buffoo's not here. Let me give you the long answer. Hey. There you go. Okay, so well, how do I spawn again? Oh, then I needed to open. I didn't even need to open Brutus. Close this. I want to go to story where it spawns Brutus. Let's go to the top of the file and look for spawn. So we can spawn a Roz mini boss. Right on. How you been, Scissor? What's up? January 3rd, 2084. So next occurrence, spawn drop. Nope. Oh, how does it spawn Brutus? I guess it's not spawn. Probably Brutus is Okay, let's find Brutus. Here we go. Spawn any Brutus 1. Really? That's how I do that? Okay. So back to where I was. Is there some? How do you jump to where you were? Forget. Forget, there's some command where you can jump back to where you were in Vim. Still learning this like crazy. Star Citizen. Okay, Captain Tusk. Captain Tusk. We want to spawn any. There we go. All right. So back there, insert any. Done. Go to the end of the line. What's the end of the line? Oh, dollar sign. I could have just done shift A. Captain Tuss, space one. Write that. Okay, let's see if we got Captain Tuss now in the middle of the screen. I don't know where the hell it's going to spawn him. No? Just put him like randomly down there. Shazzle. Okay. Spawn any. We've got to figure out why spawn any isn't doing what it's supposed to. Let's look for that. Spawn any. No, not tag. Yeah. Yeah, tag. Spawn any? No? How about action spawn? I think spawn any uses the same. Yeah, spawn any I think uses the same function here, action spawn. Let's confirm that. Finding spawn any. Yeah, it does use action spawn. All right. So back to, shit, how do you jump back to the last place you were? He's hiding. I can't figure out why he's not. Well, he's probably not. I'm just not spawning him with a certain position. I guess we could make action spawn. Have a position. Okay, why does this? I want to go to area spawn and figure out where is it spawning that. Oh, is it just trying to like spawn it smartly or something? Spending extra time fine tuning, make the game perfect is definitely worth it. Yeah. I haven't gotten to that yet. I haven't gotten to the wall boss yet. So yeah, the next few months, I'm going to be going through each one of the dungeons and spending a week on each one. So I'll spend like a week on the first dungeon, second dungeon, third dungeon, all the dungeons. And I'll be spending a week, that whole week working on the artwork for that dungeon and also the boss for that dungeon and any other little features that the dungeon needs, like adding stuff I don't even know what I'm going to add yet. But like, I'm sure there's a few things there in the dungeons. There's like, oh, it would be so much cooler if this dungeon had this or that, you know? Henko, what's up, man? Yeah, this is still C++, man. I'm just in Vim. No, paddling pool full of custard? Oh. All right, there's a key that jumps to. I think it's control square bracket. Yes, it worked. That's pretty cool. So I can jump to a certain tag. Area spawn. Where does this spawn? Oh yeah, it goes through this. Spawn is not really the thing we want here. But it I guess it could work. Uh, Okay, let's go. All right, how do I jump back? Oh, it's Control T. Yeah, that worked. All right, let's give this spawn function the ability to set a manual position. I think that'd be smarter than anything else here. Q Hefner. Totally, totally. They're into it, man. I know from experience. It's like, I don't know. I guess you're different to them. Okay, so we'll add an option, spawn any Captain Tusk, quantity one. We'll make it a vec2 position. Or a vec3, I guess. So we'll go v3f position. It'll start at 0, and then if words dot size is greater than 2 and contains words to comma. Then position dot set from words to. Think that'll work. All right. Whoa. What's up, man? Right, let's add this position here in the log statement. So at into this area at this position. I'm done with at edit. I want to go to whoops. E no, what's the B? B B B B. There we go. All right, at the end of this, I want to go position dot desk dot cster. And whoa, how did I get a preview window? Spoil, yeah, I'm spoiling stuff today for sure. All right, that should be good. Stopping that edit. Writing. I want to get rid of this preview window that somehow popped up there. I think this added a split window on the top. So like if I go Control W and then what's that? K? Yeah. And then I can quit this preview window. Cool. Oh, I feel like a Vim master, but I'm nowhere near. All right, so if we have a position and it's not zero, after it spawns the entity, it will just set the entity's pause. So we'll start editing here after this. Set position. If not position dot is zero. What? Yeah, how do I just confirm that? All right, I don't know. If not positions No, not position. Ay, ay, ay. Ah. Delete that. No. Cut. Erase that character. I'm so good at Vim, aren't I? 5 degrees. It's not, it isn't that cold, right? Buy a crossbow and 3 melons. Ugh. All right, so if the position is not zero, get the entity. I think we want to go spawn. Yeah, spawn returns an id. So we can get the entity. We want to go to the end of the line. Dollar sign. And insert. Paren. Done there. All right, now we can go E. Whoops. Not E. I E dot position dot pause equals E dot position dot last pause equals position. Done. Whew. Okay, let's see if that worked. By we'll take spawn any Captain Tusk quantity one at position. I probably should make this 0.5. I'll make this based on the area size. So 0.5, 0.5 is really what it should be. And then write that. And then back to this window, we need to make sure the position is in terms of the area size. Yeah. What's up, Nellex Dead Beef? Yeah, I got power line. This is actually airline, not power line. It's like the lightweight version of power line. Okay, so I'm gonna shift V to get all three of these lines, delete them, paste them here. And I want to get a brace here, a brace here. And I want to now put this in terms of the area's size. So position I said based on words, and then shift A, position dot. Or position dot x times equals float. Actually, this might actually work. Just area dot area size dot x. Oh, I'd open that preview window again. It's so annoying. What happened to Xcode? I'm trying to switch to Vim. I'm slowly but surely working my way to being better at Vim. It's really hard. It's really, really hard actually to try and code and talk and learn Vim. Like, learning Vim is hard enough. coding and talking is hard enough, but doing all three, it's crazy. So, okay, I'm going to yank this line. Yanking is such a funny word, right? Yank. Paste. Is it yank and put, or they call it yank and paste? I don't know. Let's change this to a Y. Find the X. Change it to a Y. And that should be it. I guess I should do this for Z. Wait, couldn't I have just gone position times equals area to area size? Let's see if that works. And let's go to the first character of the line. All right, let's see if that works. I want to run. Whew, man, dude. Did it work? It might have worked. Oh, he appeared! Yes, in the middle of the screen! It worked. Oh, it's so awesome. Barely passed math. Oh, the coffee maker gave you flirtatious glances every morning. No thanks, I'll pass. You're gonna be 14? Dude, how time flies. Yeah. Right, I just wanted to see something there real fast. Okay, good. We've got him on the screen now and at the position that we wanted. So this is taking longer than usual, coding in the next code versus coding in Vim. But once I figure out how to get Vim all, like once I get natural with Vim and things start becoming more just like automatic, it will actually be a lot faster because I'll do jumping to things in Vim is so fast. If I want to open up AI system, that was so fast compared to Xcode. But if I want to go back, oh yeah, it worked. Yay. All right, so let's delete these two lines. And I think this is good for now. We can write this, and let's go close this preview window again. Oh man, I wish I could turn that feature off, but I don't want to look up how to do that right now. Close. There, now we're back to our non-previewed window there. Okay, yeah, we do need some proper dialogue, and we need Captain Tusk, so he is, he's got a different skin for when he's on the holocom. So let's get Captain Tusk's art open. Yeah, the Eternals, I'm doing that. Yep. Thank you, Eternal Sword. Thanks for the suggestion. I am doing that already. I got it set up so when I run, right? If I just do Command R, I have this map to execute a command. That's actually executing my, you know, my make and make run. And all that. It's boring. All right. Yeah, so Captain Tusk. All right, we need a skin for when he's on the holocom, so he'll be just like all blue or something. So let's start by just doing him all a different color. We can get the skin working, and then I can actually mess with the skin, do some cool art, like the, I'm thinking like the, The wind filter, just like Zoltan suggested the other day. Zoltan was like, hey, you should check out this wind filter. He had a great suggestion. Thank you, Zoltan. So we want to turn him to be like all blue or all green. See, like all cyan. This is very Star Wars here. It's pretty good. 180-ish. Ludum dare, ludum dare. Thank you, Ichni. Okay, so I want this to be brighter too. So when he's on the holocom, it's gonna be like pretty about there. That's pretty good. And then also, we could take this layer and make it a slightly transparent so some of his color shines through. Got maybe a tiny bit of his color like that. All right. No, actually, I just want to do this all at 100% because I don't want to do every single layer just yet. There we go. Okay, so let's save this as Captain Tusk, Holocom. And render it. Yeah, Rocket Bunny, exactly. That's why I was saying that first I'm just gonna do a layer and then I'm gonna do a glitch effect like with the wind filter. All right, so Captain Tusk Hollow, put out the shadow. That should be good. Let's drop out of the shell. Make sure those files, yeah, good. We got those. Let's go back to Vim. Now that we have that, we can go to Captain Tusk's profile-y thing. I actually want to close this here because I just want these to be the five files I normally. Whoops. Oh, not bit buffer next. I want buffer delete. There. Now I've just got the five main files I'm using to edit. Go back over here, and this one I can open up Captain Tusk data. Ooh, I'm gonna add that to my C tag somehow. But for now, I'll just do edit data friends Captain Tusk. Okay, he's gonna have a new animation. This is just gonna be idle hollow or something like that. Jeez. Weissman, I'm already there, man. I'm already grateful when people give me socks. It's so great. You've upgraded from hot from chocolate milk to hot chocolate. All right, so let's shift V that, copy these lines, yank, paste, shift A to, oh wait, no, I did shift escape. Shift A. I'll call this one idle hollow. Done. Go to the hash mark. Insert hollow. Done. Write that. Back over here, we want to set the skin for Captain Tusk. I think we can set skins here. I think it's just skin Captain Tusk dash hollow. Is that right? Let's search for skin. Yeah, skin bell floating empty. Skin Captain Tusk hollow. Oh, I guess that's the only other reference we're using it for, but that should work. Okay, so we're spawning Captain Tusk, giving him the skin hollow. Hopefully that doesn't glitch with one frame where he's red and one frame where he's blue. But let's figure it out. See if it works. Awesome. I was needing some more socks. Really? Oh, that started happening to me when I was like 35. My girl started getting socks, and I freaking love it. I'm like, yeah, but I don't even buy myself socks anymore. I can't. I just wait till Christmas when I'm gonna get new socks. Okay, so there he is. He looks weird because he's, you know, we haven't made the graphic cool yet. But let's see. Let's run that again, and this time I'm gonna put it in slow motion to see if it does one frame where he's red. Because I don't want that. Actually, that might be okay. But no, I probably want to just do an animation. Watching closely. Where's he at? Come on. Show yourself. Oh, yeah, he was red. Okay, he's red at first. Damn. Well, that means, Shazzle. I want to do an animation at first anyways. Some kind of like glitch starting animation. You know what, I guess it's good enough for now just to do, to start with just making this animation look cool. So let's just start with this idle. I guess I want him to have a different flip X as well. He's blue dub, buddy ba, dabba die, dabba dee, dabba. I don't get this joke yet. Whoa, why don't I get this joke? I should be able to get this joke. Obviously better. Okay, let's make this look cool and glitchy. First of all, it should be somewhat transparent. How much transparency do you say? Well, we could make it all part of one group. That would be an easy way to make it all one transparency. No, that doesn't work. That does not work. Guess I just have to change them all by hand. All right, layer this one. Well, okay, let's guess. Maybe 80 or 70. Let's try 70. Oops. 70 70 And I got a command that should work if I just go control option command return. This should export, replace, and do all this for me. Yeah. Oh, it was a bad song. You love it for how bad it is? Okay, 70 is a little too transparent. Wah, wah. So let's try 80. This is the WTF method, everybody. Yes, it is. It's called the dong. And there are so many dongs per dollar. For real. There's like thousands. thousands of dongs. And then Hungary's got some of the craziest currency. Hungary, what's the currency in Hungary? Oh, even 80's a little too transparent. But anyways, in Hungary, I only had like $1,000 or something like that. And I went to my bank account and like, or the ATM, and I was like, how much money do I have? And I had like 14 million of my currency in Hungary. It was crazy. Their dong is weak compared to the euro. So either 85 or 90. Let's try 90. Yay. And then we'll do some glitchy effects. The forint. Is that what it's called? Really? Wonder I couldn't remember it. Anyways, if you want to be crazy rich, just go to Hungary and look at your ATM balance. I guess 90 is about right. Okay, let's make him glitch. Let's try just one frame at first and make it glitch. What's this filter called? It's called wind. Wind, where is it? Video? No. Oh, stylized wind. This is a pretty good one for trying this little glitch thing, I think. Oh, that's kind of cool. Whoa. So random. I like have no control over that. I mean, it'd be pretty easy just to draw that anyways. But okay, let's see what one frame glitched out looks like. If it was called the four wild, that'd be loopy. Nice one. I like that. Oh, this is so great. We can make great jokes like that. You're such, dude, you deserve like the gold star of the week for jokes right there. Yes. Oh, he's just really, really slow. Okay, well, we need that to run a lot faster. Wait. So Captain Tusky's got 0.618 for this holo sequence, which means that I probably want to turn this down all the way to 0.1. Okay, change to the end of the line, 0.1. Okay, let's run that at that speed and see if that's about right for the glitchy part. And then if it needs to be faster, we need to go all the way down to 0.05. Actually, that 0.1's all right. So now we need to make every single one of these frames 0.6 long, except for this one. Oh, did I destructively do this layer? I did. Okay. I want to undo that, go back to this layer, duplicate it before I do this, and then do the wind or whatever it was I did. Let's try this one this time. Instead of the blast, we'll try the wind one. And I'm thinking in this frame too, he's also going to be more transparent. So let's take him down to maybe 80. And once again, all these are going to become 0.6 or maybe a little more. I guess 0.6, yeah. All right, and this frame is a little different. It's got 0.5 of its normal and then 0.1 of its glitch, so it'll look something like this. It's starting to look good. Let's do a little bit of like weird. We'll shift him a little bit. So in this frame, this one will be 0.5, and this one will be 0.1, and he can just move 2 pixels to the left. So it looks a little like he's just glitching. I guess it's all right. Let's move him a little more. Actually, let's do something where his lower half is a little less glitched. Hot chocolate! Can't trust him. Can't trust the hologram. Not in the slide. That was cool. That looked good. Okay, cool. Let's render this and see how it looks in the game. I wonder what I'll do for an intro for this effect. I'm thinking that somehow he just appears, but like maybe a bright flash of light or something. Yeah, I'm liking this. I do want to see a little bit more though. So some of these. Yeah, this is looking good. It's definitely giving you the impression that this is a hologram. I want to see a couple more frames like this, but with less of this, like the same kind of thing as like this, but just less of it. So let's do this first frame, start with this last frame. This will be 0.5, this will be 0.1. We'll duplicate this before we destructively edit it. And this time, I just wanna see it barely done, so actually, maybe we can just shift some of his pixels like this manually. Let's do one more, but this time, just barely. I really want to see it like even less. See how that looks. You mean you didn't see right through him from the start? Oh man, you're good at this. Good. This is looking pretty good. Let's see what it looks like. So how are we gonna do the intro to this effect? Yo! It's not very Captain Tusky for him to just say yo. Good start. Okay, we need an intro. Let's start drawing. I'm thinking like a brown. Like, it's just like a hologram thing that just appears, right? So the energy is coming from, it's like a thing you wear, right? So it's probably something you would, that Rock sees in his visor anyway. So this is all appearing just in his visor. It's not like the hologram is actually there, which we are all seeing through this, right? So what that means is you can basically do any kind of visual effect and it should feel right. So, yeah, I'm thinking like this, like light appears sort of. It's really bright and it's like, boom, it comes in like that. All right. So we can go file. Let's save this as, actually, before we do this, let's check everything in so far. I'm really loving the Control Z and the FG commands. I love that. Let's check all this in. That's a lot of frames for this animation, but it's what we need to make it look right. And besides, Texture Packer is smart enough to pack the frames that are exactly the same into the same sprite. So this is not actually filling up the sprite sheet that much. It's just filling up the list of sprites, which is really just data. Lines, simple lines, not filling up the texture. Okay, so far, what have we changed in this edit? We took Captain Tusk and made him his own entity. Oh, I commented out those delay things. I should undo that. Yeah, what's... How'd you fix the problem? Thanks, Ichini. Appreciate it, man. Okay, let's undo these edits. Captain Tusk. Spawn any Captain Tusk skin, Captain Tusk Hollow. I guess these should have a comment in front of them. So it's not actually messing with the existing dialogue in this atomic commit. You just picked the one that liked the most of the things I like. There you go. Weissman's like boring. But it works, right? All right, we'll get this all fixed anyways. I don't really need to worry about this too much. Captain Tusk is now its own entity. The story system can spawn an entity at a position. And we got all these graphics files to add. Just add that all. All right, now we need another animation for him to start his hollow. You just want to have an excuse to go to Larry's Crab Shack for dinner twice in a row. All right. We need so like an animation called like Hollow Start. Hollow Start's fine. All right, Shift V, D, oops, I guess I need to D that. Now we got a copy of that. We can change to end of line, call that, oops. End, and then find the capital S, change to hash mark, hollow, oh, whoops, no, I didn't want to do that. Undo, and then just make this reversed. Man, I'm starting to get the hang of Vim, man. You can't find a good French restaurant? I know the feeling, man. We moved to the Bay Area a little while ago. We can't find anything. But you'll find it, man. You'll eventually find it. Hey, remember that time we had an American amicable solution to a potential social awkwardness? It's so true. It's so true. All right, so now we'll start this animation. Captain Tusk, hollow start. And get this other Captain Tusk animation back open. All right, so where's my... tablet. I'm so glad you're still working. After all the times I dropped you on the ground. We got that. Got this. I get some water. Anybody else want some water? All right, so let's delete all these frames. Now we need a frame to start with where it's like almost like pure white light. Let's enable this background. Well, that's weird. Is there some way I can, I guess I just have to deal with it. Okay, one frame. Let's get this color. But wait, oh. We'll turn off the hue saturation for now. We're gonna work with pure white anyways. Almost pure white. Well, yeah, we'll go with pure white. So this can kind of take the hue of the hue saturation thing. So, there we go. Got one frame. Why are there so many cars? Oh, I know. You guys have it right. In Holland, with so many bikes you have. I love that. That's like one of my favorite parts about Holland. Because there's so much road. All right, so we got a frame of him like that. Let's get a frame where he is like squished. All right, another frame. Squish him some more. Squish him. I know, more diversity. I know. I know, sexism and racism, it's weird, right? Yeah, that's one thing I really noticed when I was in your country too. You guys have a very good tolerance. Everything is tolerance towards people and their outlooks and their and stuff, you know? You very good, healthy outlook on everything there in Holland. All right, let's see what that looks like all together. All together now. This frame. That frame. That frame. And then we'll end with this frame. Too slow. In a pile of bleach. Uh. This part's too slow. What if this was 0.3 or 2? Still too slow. This has got to be like 0.4 even. And we're going to need to see that super faster. Super faster. So good at English. Okay, there, we got that set up. Let's render that. Hollow tusk, hollow start. Good. Now we should have this ready to go, right? We got hollow start and hollow end. All right, let's implement this. You guys have trampolines in the floor or the playgrounds? That's awesome. I think we can use a spawn type. So we'll go open up constants.h. Look for a spawn. Look for K spawn. Ah, there we go. We want like K spawn teleport, but oops. Oh shit. Undo. Yeah, like K spawn teleport, but change to. That didn't work. Undo. How do I change to a tab character? Maybe I press tab. Change to tab. That works! Oh, so cool. Really? French fries are Belgian? I didn't know that. Shows you what I know. K spawn hollow. That just means that we're spawning and we want it to spawn with the spawn type hollow. Okay, I guess in the background I'll start compiling that. All right, now we've got spawn type hollow, and we want to be able to look that up as a word, so we need to open up constants.cpp, search for the same thing. Can I just press N? No? Oh, that's not a word. No problem. All right, we just go back to action spawn. Oh my God, I love how fast that jump to is. Fried ground apple slivers. They cut a deal with the French. They gave them the fries. Right, so we'll make this just K spawn none first. And then if words.size is greater than 3, if Words three is teleport in. End of word. If it's teleport in, then spawn flags equals K spawn teleport. Delete to the end of the line. Wait, how do I do that? Delete to the semicolon. That works. All right, shift A. Else if words three equals hollow. Then spawn flags equals K spawn hollow. Done. What's up, AnoahNet? Yo, how you doing, man? Touch pirates with a speech impediment. All right, so now we want to go back to the spawn function, which is here. Control bracket. Yeah, and then if we're using the spawn type, else if has bits flags, is that right? Spawn flags. Okay, change to the end of the line. Spawn flags, has been spawn flags, K spawn hollow. Shift A. Man, it's starting to become a little more natural, a little bit. The clearly Canadian revival. Nice. Really? There was a New Holland? Oh, what's up? Noah, you bought another copy of the game? Thank you, man. That's so great. I would have sent you another mail. Did you buy the $16 version or the $32? If you already have if you bought the $32 version and you already have a key, then it doesn't matter. You can just give the key to your friend. But if it's a $16 version, then you'll probably want to just write me an email so I can change. I can have his email address to send it to him. I'll need to send him a key when he gets the game. So basically, if you send me his email address, it's probably better if it's a $16 version. All right, so if we have spawn hollow, we want the entity to have his animation. This is pretty simple. It's just E dot render dot set animation to be hollow start repeat 0 afterwards k idle k forever and his skin e to render dot skin equals dash hollow. And we probably want to do that same stuff we're doing down there with e.ai.timer. So was that cool? Was that clear? And no, Annette? All good? Yeah. e.ai.timer equals 0.618f. Okay, and now we shouldn't need... Okay, let's go back and... We don't want to do the segues for now. Oops. So insert a semicolon. Done. Insert semicolon. All right. And back to here. Cut or delete those. Oh, we shouldn't need this one. Write that. And that's it, right? Oh, wait, no, we need spawn Annie, Captain Tusk, 1, 0.5, 0.5, hollow. Run that. Should do the hollow animation. Whoa, wait, I didn't say the hollow. I didn't set the timing for the hollow animation yet. All clear? Oh, sweet. Awesome, man. Oh, that looks all right. We'll see it a little slower, though. Voidball is the best sport in the world. My favorite team is Southampton Zegen, boss. Steve Trebby! What's up, man? Spoiler alert, stream. Working on story elements, critical story elements. How you been, man? What's new? Hello. That looks good. Oh, yeah, we want to go to Captain Tusk. Which, do we have that open? Where is it at? Ah, how do I get to that buffer? Okay, first of all, Control W up. Close this preview window. Where did that come from? If I just go backwards, there he is, Captain Tusk. Yay, idle hollow. No, I want hollow start to be way faster. Let's try, hold on. Yeah, Viminit, man, Viminit. Vimin. Okay, so change to end of line. Make those 0.5. Once again, change to end of line. This actually kind of helps to like verbally talk out all the Vim commands. It's actually really helping a lot. Let's see how that looks with a little bit faster. No habla. It's no habla. Or sorry, no hablo. No hablo español. Hablo español un poquito. He's just like, yo. And he stays there. What happens if we go away now? Come back. Okay, he's gone. That's good. Alright, good. So that did that look fast enough? Let's try a little faster, actually. How long have you been vimming it? About... Off and on for like the last month, I've been trying to learn Vim, but only in the last week or so have I really just finally kind of gained competence, just barely being able to competently do stuff. And then just the last couple days, it even got better. So I'm starting to like actually be able to Vim on stream. Testicles. Your hovercraft is full of eels? Oh, Duolingo, right? Which language are you working on? Jameson's comme une pomme de terre. I like potatoes. I love potatoes. I am a party dog. Oh, I feel like a potato. All right, Ainoa. You're trying to win me over to Hemax. It's probably not gonna happen. Just gonna let you know. Okay, that looked pretty good, right? He did a nice animation. It was faster this time. Let's see it in slow motion to make sure that it's not showing one frame of him when he's red. All right, paying attention. He shouldn't be red for the first frame. Yes, good, he appears. Nice, that looked good. Good, we got a nice little animation. It's not doing anything wrong with all that. We do want him to disappear though after he's done talking. So I think that means we want to render, once he's done talking. We need to do a skin. We need an idle. So go idle invisible format empty dot ping delay 1.0. There, so now he's got an invisible. Oh, you're learning Spanish? Nice. My mom's doing that too. My mom just showed me Duolingo last week. I'm like, wow, this is pretty cool. Duolingo. It's a mighty fine tuber. Idle invisible. Okay, so after he's done talking, we want to animate Captain Tusk. Hollow end, don't repeat, and set his skin. To invisible. Does that work? Do we have an action animate? Yeah, I think so. Story in him. Whoops. Story in him, find the character, run the animation, right? String in him's float delay. I think this is what this is supposed to be. Run it. Also, there's unspawn. I think there's unspawn where you can delete a character. Yo! So we run the text. We should disappear after this. Ah. Okay, so I think what happened was he should be running his idle animation after this. Okay, so we want to animate hollow end idle forever. Alright, HD, see you, man. Later. Yeah, nice, that worked. So cool. He did his idle animation after that, which turned him invisible. He should still be actually technically be there. Which, does that mean that he is blocking? Yeah, he is blocking. So it'd be better just to unspawn him. I think there's an unspawn command. Let's see if we got that. Action unspawn? No, we got unlock exits. We don't have unspawn. There's no like action remove. Like, what if you were standing right where he was? Yeah, there's a lot of little things to figure out here. If you were standing right in the middle of the screen, right when he was supposed to spawn too, that would look really weird. So there's got to be some smarter way that he can spawn a good position. And obviously now we need to make him so he can unspawn. Yes, NeoVim. That's what I'm going to be doing. NeoVim. For sure. That's my next move, is to convert from Vim to NeoVim. I've heard it works perfectly. Like, it's like there's no more issues with it at all. And it's got the asynchronous, and it's got, you can run a terminal inside it. Mutinous, what's up? Why does the hologram have collisions in the first place? It's true, right? Why? Why? Well, it's because he's using the Captain Tusk's entity, and Captain Tusk already... You know what? Captain Tusk... What if I do take away his collision? Would that... If I go to back to the ship's bridge, does that mean I can walk on top of him? Or does he have like a static entity around him? Oh yeah, he does have a static entity. Right, running an OS inside my OS. Oh, you had some issues getting Vim plugins to work? Which plugins? The holodeck manufacturing malfunction. Alright, so can I walk on top of him? No! Okay, good. This is all... Oh, I don't really need to have him... have a collision, I guess. But it'd be better if I ever wanted to spawn... Wait, no. He's mostly going to be an entity that spawns with a holo. But no, there is going to be maybe one scene where he actually is an entity where you can walk around him, like if he's at the party. So... Ah, screw it. I guess if he's at the party, he could also be on top of some kind of platform or something like that. He's the captain. Yeah, screw it. We'll put him on top of something if he's ever going to be an entity. All right, that's good. Good call, Mutinous. We'll make him just have no collision. And I should put a note here about it. So I want to insert before this line. I guess I could just go like this. This is really inefficient. All right, insert after this text. All right, semicolon. No collision so that he doesn't block when he is a hologram. Oh, you know what? Shit, I got a better way to do this. Let's leave it like this. Let's take away this line. Make him have a collision. Whoops. And then when we use the spawn type holo, spawn, there we go. Yeah, spawn type holo, we'll just remove his collision component. You forgot what plugin? Okay, so it didn't work in Vim, or it didn't work in NVim. What's up, Cropper? Yeah, I stream every day, man. I probably should put something about that on Twitter more often, huh? Like, hey, I'm streaming. I used to do that. Yeah, okay, so we want to go entity, remove component. Do I press tab? Yeah. And then not that one. Oh man, which one do I do? Remove component. I think it's like this. This is one of those things, like, I don't know, because I'm not using Xcode. I don't know whether this is like a template function or not. I forgot. And you complete me wasn't telling me whether it's a template function. So entity remove, let's just try this. Entity remove component, collision component. And then from entity e.id. Is that how this works? I can't remember. I guess we'll just run it, see if it fails. Oh yeah, I gotta start doing that then. I'll put some more notices on Twitter when I'm streaming. Did that work? It did work. All right, I'm glad I remembered that right, but I wish I would have known how to do that from Vim. Like Vim didn't even know that was a template method. Didn't even suggest it. Okay, he should still we still shouldn't be able to walk around. Yeah, we still got these collision boxes, so we can't really tell. But if I go into God mode and then yeah, I can't walk around him. So he's got a collision box. All right, so edit, insert a dash there. Oh, it changed. Oh, this is one area where Vim is not that cool either. It doesn't automatically load the file. Even though I set this in my VimRC to reload the file, it doesn't reload the file sometimes. Yeah, mutinous, that'll be one of the things I gotta do next, is to make it so he spawns at a different place. You don't like C tags? I really like C tags. Really? So there's R tags and G tags. There's so many tags. So far, I've only been using C tags since this morning, but it's working amazing. I customized it though. I made sure to customize its options and stuff. So it doesn't show me stuff I don't want, and it only shows me the files I would ever want to open. Alright, wait. I don't want to write this. Just go back and then load the file again. And then repeat the edit. Run it. Okay, so there. Now he shouldn't have a collision component when he's a hologram. R-Tags is clang based. That sounds good. Good, yeah, he's gone. He never was here. Let's see that with the debug view on. Yeah, good. So he doesn't even have a collision box at all. Good. Well, that's great. So now any entity that gets spawned and is spawned with the type hologram will automatically start its hologram and it won't have a collision component. So that's good. But now we still need to make it so he can spawn at about the right position. Oh, that's just so easy. Actually, we take the current position that we, well, why this little preview window annoys me. Anywhere near Xcode, IntelliSense, yeah. Yeah, limiting the shown list is pretty cool. SFML, I haven't checked it out, man. Dog tags. Doggo. Doggy. Let's get rid of this little window. Freaking little window. There's gotta be some you complete me option I can turn off there. Alright, oh yeah. When the entity spawns. That was a use of C tags right there. I just opened up a C tag real quick. Action spawn. Right, when we set the position, we want to make sure it's a good position. So shift A to start editing at the end of the line, insert a bracket. Position equals move system. Get any valid position given. Oh, dude, it stops showing me the helpful advice as soon as I close that. That's kind of weak. As soon as I type the left parentheses here, it's going to stop showing me the guide or whatever for this. And it opened the freaking preview window again. Ah, the little things. It's the little things that count, right? Little things you got to figure out how to tweak and get your Vim just right. Anyways, get any valid position for... All right, so we want to do id, pause, size, mask, and something. What's that last thing? Bool, allow, edges. All right. I wish there was a way to like... This is Xcode so much better about that. So it's for any position size mask. Any position size mask. Allow edges, true. Done editing, shift A, insert that. All right, there, now it should be getting any valid position. So if the player is standing in the very middle of the screen and it tries to spawn, it should put him somewhere near there, but not right on him. So let's see if that works. By we'll do a little bit of delay. How much delay do we have? Lens shake and IMS alarm. Delay 1.5. We still have 1 second to get there. So I have 1 second to get to the middle of the screen before he spawns. Let's run it. See what happens. He shouldn't be able to step on. Oh, his move mask. Does he have a move mask? He might not even have a move mask. Oh, damn. It's too short. Okay, so anyways, we'll make this delay longer. And I gotta make sure he's got a good move mask. Life is like an accounting department staffed by midgets. Oh, such wisdom. Back to Captain Tusk. Where the hell is he? There he is. Yeah, he doesn't have a move. But if he did, he would have a mask. He would not be able to step on static. Can't step on other friends, neutrals, switches, containers, water, or sky. Or, well, I guess exits would be another one too. All right, let's see if that works though. Hijit Brood. That means, oh damn it, it didn't work. Did I get there in time? All right, what was that function? Action spawn. And at the end of this, we're setting a proper position. Well, here's where I need to go switch to Xcode because I can't really set a breakpoint inside Vim yet. He eats bread, that's all. All right, I'm setting a breakpoint here to make sure this works or see what's happening. Because it should be setting a valid position for him because Rock has the category friend and shouldn't be valid position. So the pause we're trying for is, yeah, right in the middle of the screen. The size, oh, his size is wrong. Oh, because we deleted his collision? Yeah, because we deleted his collision. Oh, it makes sense now. Okay, well, that's pretty easy to explain. Okay, so we need to get a proper size. If size is zero, then size is just area block size. At least it should be something, right? And then we just pass size. And then we'll also do that same kind of thing for mask, because mask could be wrong too. Edad moved on mask. And then if mask is zero, we'll do mask equals k default. No k filter. Default, no, K filter. Yeah, that's it. K filters default mask. Ah. And then use mask here. And we'll once again set a breakpoint so that we can confirm all this. Eris Brat. El Compan. I'll spunk your pan. Size equals E collision size is going to be empty. Yep. All right, so after this, we say it's zero. So size becomes area block size, which is 20 by 12, the size of one block. All right, mask starts off at E. I moved out mask, and it is something valid, so it's not going to go and set it to a filter's default mask. So there, now we should be able to take position, which starts at X 210, 120, and call, filter it through this function, and position becomes 0, 0. Ay, 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 man. What the hell happened? You're uninvited for my dinner parties. So get any valid position, wasn't able to find any valid position at all. Is that it? Maybe his, wait, what if we do block size times 0.8? This time the size is a little smaller, right? Yeah, 16 by 9.6. And this time does it work for getting a valid position? It does. 210, 108. So put it down a little bit lower. So the problem was that the block size was so big that it tried to... The get any valid position algorithm is not perfect. It's like... trying to find positions that line up exactly with tiles. So that's why using a size value that's a tiny bit smaller than a whole tile works there. So this should work now. Let this run and you should appear just below, which is kind of weird, right? You shouldn't really appear like that, should he? It's better than him appearing right on top of him, I guess. Is there a better way? There's gotta be. Trampoline in it too. Oh man, I'm getting tired of coding. This is looking good though. I'm gonna check this in and think about how to maybe do a better solution for him appearing in. Yeah, I do have another solution. There's like where it can spawn at any position or on the screen, but it tries to spawn him a little bit away from the player. So yeah, there's gotta be some kind of solution where can spawn better. Oh, that's probably what was going on with the spawn function in the first place. Oh shit, that's actually probably what it is. So let's try turning off his position and his size was a whole one, so that's why that function was failing. So let's do 0.8 by 0.8. And then we should be able to take that stories entity and we shouldn't need to do this anymore. with the position, we just want to do hollow. I think we have to do that, which is weird. We have to put it, this has to be the third argument, which is just kind of wrong. But let's see if it works. So that should, let's see if he spawns now at any position, but that's going to be kind of far from the player. What was the checksum for this week? The checksum is a function that basically, I'll explain. Yeah, it worked. There we go. So now he's, since I'm in the middle of the screen, he chose to be down at the bottom of the screen there. Cool. That works. And now we didn't even need to have this position thing anymore. So yeah, is the checksumming is it's not a Steam requirement, and it is indirectly, it will help with save file cheats. Or not save file cheats, but if people change their data. So but really the real point of it is I played the game on my friend's laptop last week and it didn't work. Like it was able to play the intro, it was able to play the menu, but as soon as it tried to get into the game, it just hung. Just an hourglass cursor. And I was like, what? It's not working. And I didn't really give it much thought then. I was like, sorry guys, we can't play the game. So afterwards I realized it might have downloaded wrong, because I noticed when it was downloading from Steam that it took forever, right? And so his internet connection was like really weird. And I know it's happened before to some other players where it was a corrupt download. Like that happened to, I think it was Zilton actually. Zilton downloaded his game and it just didn't work because it was actually a corrupt download. So he had to delete it, reinstall it, and he actually had to do that twice. And finally he deleted it, reinstalled it, and it worked. But that's because his internet connection was crazy at that time. So the real point of it all was that I wanted to checksum the game, the important parts of the game's data, like the assets files, so that it verifies if it downloaded correctly. And so now it's got a little thing, like if I go and run the game at the start, let me show you. If I turn off this no checksum fail, it'll act like it does the first time you run the game. And if I don't skip the menu, we'll see that it's gonna, basically the checksum is a lot different than it was the last time I released the game. So it's gonna give me a warning here. So it's like corrupt download, Songbringer may not have downloaded correctly. Please uninstall and re-download the game to ensure that it runs as intended. And this is even showing you that this is the checksum. And this is the checksum it was expecting. And so all it's really doing is it's checksumming all of the important data files, which are in the assets folder. It's really just the data folder. All these things are actually super critical, especially entities.txt and world.txt. These things are, if you even one letter is off, if it's a corrupt download, the game might not even run. So I'm pretty sure that's what was happening to my friend on my friend's computer. So there's that, and yeah, and then also error reporting. So if that's not the issue on my friend's computer, then I'll have an error reporting feature soon where it can send me his log.txt and his saves.txt. So yeah, so that's basically it. All right, I guess that's gonna be it for today's stream. Yeah, so I gotta go, I want to take one before I check in my code. I'm going to take a break right now and do some dinner and stuff. But before I check in my code later on tonight, what I'm going to do is take one little look at this and see if I can make this cleaner, right? Why do I need to have a freaking underscore right there? I'll just make that function action spawn a little smarter about how it interprets the spawn type. And then I might even take this out, the position, because it's not being used anymore. So I don't know, might not even need it. So yeah, so the rest of the things I'm working on tonight and tomorrow are going to be mostly story elements, things like that. You see me working on Captain Tusk being able to holocom in. So there'll be a lot more story elements where you can holocom in and say stuff and maybe give you quests or something, give you items, who knows. Yeah, a hologram giving you items. That'd be funny. Anyways, thanks a lot for the laughs, you guys, and thanks for your support. So we'll see y'all next time. Later.